What do you do with an 87 K car that has 37,000 original kilometers on it? I don't know. A question we've been struggling with for a long time at DEBOSS. Andrew at Tuesday had this car come in. It needs work, it needs brakes, and it needs rocker panels because it's a 30-year-old car from Canada. Whether it gets used or not, it needs work. But it was just too good to do nothing with. And the demand for parts for this car, zero. So there's no chance of anybody making any money off of it selling parts. So if you've watched DEBOSS for a while, you've seen this car in the background. And we've had some fun with it. The guy that had this car before, just want to show you. Okay, this is the story that I imagine happened with this car. This was grandma's car that she drove once a week to church and to bingo. Didn't put any kilometers on it, but when grandma had her license taken away, she gave it to Bobby, her grandson, who loved this car for about 3 months. He got all the split lume on it and covered everything up. He painted the cylinder head silver because that looks awesome. Managed to get some paint on the block as well. And I think it might even have natural gas. I'm not even sure. Oh, hi, kitty. Sony CD player that has the 10 disc in the trunk. Added some LED lights, I think, for in the back window. If you can see that, the LEDs there. We've got some custom turn signals at the back here. And in the trunk, we have a Sony 10 disc CD player. Oh, you guys don't know the trouble of having to take this thing out and pop it in your 10 discs. But love the car so much that it even comes with the factory radio, Chrysler radio. What do we do with this car? Well, these cars are actually going up in value because they're so terrible that everybody destroyed them. K-car's done, let's crush it. I've seen woodchuck wagons go for $7,000, $8,000, $9,000, which is ridiculous. But it's kind of cool that this car kind of saved the Chrysler Corporation. Chrysler did three things right in a very short period of time. That was the minivan, that was the K car, and they started putting Cummins in their trucks. And if it wasn't for all those three things, probably wouldn't be Chrysler around anymore. So what's happening, it's actually going to one of our other sponsors, VNR. They're picking it up today and they are giving it to somebody who collects these things maybe. So it's not going too far, but it's going on to people that would appreciate it more. We've had some fun with it. We really don't know what to do with it. I'm not gonna work on it. So now we're gonna clean it up. It runs, turn the key, it fired right up. Might drive to town real quick on a garage plate, throw some fuel in it. And that is it for the K car. So I wish there was more to the story. That's about it. Anyway, here we go. So last ride in the K car. This might be the very last time that I ever drive the Reliant K. I tried so hard to get this on Canada's Worst Driver, not to smash up, but like one of those transition shots or whatever. And they were interested and then they weren't. It was the history of the cars. This car has history. Everybody knows somebody who had one, got driven around in, got picked up in, and for soccer practice or piano lessons, whatever. It really is a terrible, terrible car. But on to bigger, better things. Here we go.